Oh. Oh, well. Here we go again. Same kind of magic. Elves versus infects. Trying to fight the coronavirus with elves. Elves are said to be quite resilient, right? But they are also very old. They're like hundreds of years old. Thank you. Thank you, Stoneheart. There's a couple of things I want to do with the stream, but they're gonna, I guess, both time and money. So if he's gonna attack there, I'm definitely gonna block. Like in either case, we're trading one for one. Either for the creature or for a remove a spell. I usually say I don't do that when they attack on a second turn because the odds of them having a second turn kill are not that high. But if I can trade like this, I'm down. Here we're gonna go with just this. Fetch Dryad Arbor and then try to glimpse them next turn. Oh, they only have three cards. Okay, okay. Well, der Kartenladen. Thank you so much. You're from Hamburg. So if you guys ever are in Hamburg, check them out. Der Kartenladen. They also have an awesome stream. What do you stream, by the way? Do you stream Legacy at a good time? Are you, by the way, are you open for tournaments again? I know that, like, around Munich, stores are slowly opening up again for like, smaller tournaments. The Ponda did not shuffle. Oh, Pendlehaven, that's such a good card. Oh, it's the wrong artwork, though. This is like the Toxic Forest artwork. Wait. You got something? You waited a long time on attacks. No damage? Okay, fine. Oh, you started. Oh, that's amazing. Weekly. Saturdays? 7 library, okay. Sounds good. Is Jan still around or is he traveling the world? Like last time I spoke to him, his WhatsApp was changing all the time to different surf locations and stuff. So I was wondering whether he was like out in the world surfing somewhere. Days, I will pay. I'm down. Okay, let's see what we can do. Is there like a world where I go another this and then I go for this and then I go for... No, that's not good. Sentinel. Stupid fly in my face all the time. That is Sentinel. No. Okay, this is really weird. Never mind. We'll try again. He's around. Say hello to him. I'd be surprised if he didn't pay 8 life there. Just 4 life, okay. And a land. That's not a fetch land. Whenever there's something that doesn't immediately strike me as, oh, this makes sense, I'm scared. And it looks like he got it. Okay. And we have exactly... Well, he could have done it with Pendlehaven either way. And he goes for the attack. He sees the line. He sees the line. He's got the... He had the turn 4 kill. We had the turn 4 kill. Okay. So... Something like this, right? You guys remember how I sideboarded last time? It's something like this. You're so jealous. How come? Because they have tournaments.
Awaken, my child, and embrace the glory that is your birthright.
Man, I don't know. I really want to play. I really want to try the Plague Engineers at least. They feel so cute, so cool. You know what? We're gonna try them. They can also attack and block. Like, oh, Julian, you. They could. They do. Yes, they do. Serve the hive.
I control the gloom. Serve the hive.
You just got randomly matched up again, which makes sense, right? Because we just finished the league. And I guess he must have also just finished the league. And then we queued up again and Magic Honor was like, hey, sweet, you guys just play again. Oh god, this is such a bad hand. I was gonna say I hate having crowd over my opening hand, but here it might actually be okay. Nah, I want the extra mana. Can you imagine if Plague Engineer was green, we could actually send it for Plague Engineer, that would make the Vero so much worse. But really just be like carriers on carriers. And then you natural order. You couldn't even natural order. I guess if you get some kind of creature type they haven't named yet. They should have made Plague Engineer an elf. Mark my words. You guys would vote for me, right? If I was to run for president of Wizards, do they have a president? In America everything has a president. Would you vote for me? You would. Let's just all buy shares and make me the president of Wizards so we can finally get Leyline of the Choke. Tropical. I like that artwork, by the way. I wanna hang out there. I bet there's like tons of like toxic venomous creatures in the sea there. Wait, I got nothing? What? Is this gonna be end of turn abrupt decay, end of turn thingy then? Crop rotation? This feels like end of turn crop rotation. This very much feels like end of turn crop rotation, but... can't put my finger on it. Should have attacked first. Actually, no, I'm too... This makes it actually look like I have abrupt decay, which is kinda nice. On the other hand, it doesn't stop the Ankmoth Nexus. Oh, no! Okay, no crop rotation. Nice. Can we do anything about the Nexus? We have Plague Engineer. I just shaked my hand and you just like kept sitting on my hand. What kind of fly are you? Oh, and we draw this? Too bad. Pierce, repay, okay. Let's drop Virtual Rangers into, I don't know, Metal Sentinel or something. Okay. Okay. Looks to be a slow start from them as well. Closing the Dinos. 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, we can attack for 6 next turn, I guess. Oh, Wasteland. Yeah, actually, I want them to Wasteland me. Makes it less likely to... Oh, well, there goes my idea of them being less likely to have something. Abrupt Decay, maybe? Come on, this guy. It's funny, Pendulaven actually does nothing for combat because the creature dies in the upkeep then anyway. So I really want to set it up in a way that makes it look as if we had Abrupt Decay. Okay. Okay, now I don't need to represent Abrupt Decay. This is unblockable. Uncounterable. I wonder whether playing the Pendlehaven Post Combat actually slight gave away that we don't. Oh god. Oh god, that's even better. Plague Engineer one time. Plague Engineer one time. And the crowd goes. Mild. And this is just so bad. Maybe I should really just sit back and try to maximize what I have here. Like the only attack I could do is like this, maybe. This, but he would block. He would block either way. I think we are just not doing anything here. And then if you draw a glimpse, you can try to do something. But this doesn't look good for us. Uh-oh, another land makes me feel becoming immense. Or like, you know, becoming immense, some crazy stuff. Mine's a fast foot because it's 2 mana, basically. Okay. Just this one, right? He knows that I've got nothing. Like, what am I have? Beast Within? Don't have Beast Within, I can tell you so much. Okay, just this. Oh, by the way, we can't even draw. Like, I was like, hey, what if you draw Natural Order? Yeah, that's not an out. What if you draw Cradle? That's probably also not an out. No. Well, I guess it could have helped if I had played. Yeah, we were just like looking to draw Glimpse here. Abrupt Decay. Huh. Abrupt Decay, the Graft Digger's Cage. So we're on 6. That's a world where we Abrupt Decay the Graft Digger's Cage, and then we hope he's got nothing. Like, if he had anything, right? If he had Berserk, we would have died. If he had Invigorate, we would have died. If he had... if he had Become Immense, we probably would have died. If he had... Yeah, we would have died Become Immense. The only reasonable thing I can see is our second Wines, and we are not beating our second Wines. We are not beating our second Wines, even if I Abrupt Decay the Noble Hierarch. We're not beating a second Wines, and all the other ones he didn't have previously, so what if I Abrupt Decay this? What if I Abrupt Decay this, then I play this, then I get 4 mana. Can draw an extra card. Have I played a land already? I have not. That case. The whale. Yeah, but we don't care about whale because we can't beat it. We're actually gonna try to play a little bit around Flusterstorm by going like this, I think. Maybe, I hope I didn't like. I guess it doesn't play around Flusterstorm anyway. It makes it so that if they have Flusterstorm, it's gonna be one less to pay, but I guess we couldn't pay. We could actually pay for those by... No? Okay. Visionary. Okay, all of this is good. Like, all of this gives us a really good next turn. But we basically need them to not have anything this turn. Okay, hit me. Hit me. You got that second Wines? Or maybe you draw something for a turn? Brainstorm. Oh, that gives him. He sees 4 cards for the turn, basically. I guess the Brainstorm is the one card. We already know Brainstorm is not the out. Shepard plays around Flusterstorm. That's a really good. That's a really good insight. Yeah. Okay, so what if you get to untap 3, 4, 5, 6? Not even sure if we get there. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Probably do. blockers. Okay. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. He's got 3 blockers. Oh, it's not good enough. It's probably not good enough. So he's got 3 blockers. So even if we have like those attacking, that's not good enough. On the other hand, wait, if he blocks with this, then... Oh no, but he's still... he's got enough. He's got enough either way. Oh no, wait, this one blocks, so he wouldn't. So if those two die, then he doesn't have. So he can only like block 2 and still kill us. So he blocks 2 and that's 15. 16 fucking 17. I can't believe it. We are one short. Maybe I should have gotten in there. Is there a way to see infect damage on my overlay? That's actually a really good point. I have 8 infect right now, but I should actually implement that in the future. I have 8 infect right now. It's 8 infect right now. I should implement that in the future. That's just like no way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Block, block. Oh, wait. This is oh no, it's not plus, right? Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Block, block. 5, 10, 15. 2 block. 5, 10, 15, 16, 17. That's just like no way. Can't believe. Oh, the second Ink Month Access really kills us. I was so happy we got to untap. Is there any way where I played Nettles? Where I played this one? 1, 2, 3. Oh no, then this one doesn't even untap. Yeah, that's. Plague Engineer would have been insane, by the way. Plague Engineer would have been absolutely insane. Why would he fetch? Alright, I just lost connection to chat, so maybe some said something about fetching in chat. Imagine if we had Invigorate. Actually no, Invigorate would just add 1 damage. Yeah, I guess there's nothing we can have here. That gets us GG's. Man, I bet Plague Engineer is the next card, come on. No, it's not. Okay, it's very far away. It's very far. Oh god, we only have shit on top. Never mind, we lost. We're not dealing enough damage. We could only do 5, 10, 15 to them. So there's no way we can kill them. Even if they had to fetch. I think I'm gonna go to the bathroom real quick. Where's my Be Right Back button, by the way? I used to have one. I think it's here. Did I actually get rid of my Be Right Back button? How do I go to the bathroom without my Be Right Back button? Oh, it's... no. Okay, you'll just have to do without... Where's my Be Right Back button? I can't believe it. Did I actually get rid of it? My next match is already coming up. Okay, in that case, we'll just play. The Innistrad Revenue Service. Yeah, let's try this. This is just beat down Elves solo over again. Oh yeah, the 17 was basically like my good name says. So if we can draw Cradle, then there's a world where we can get to 17, but that's still not enough. I think they were at 18. Like, either way I did it, I felt like we were one short. Give us goblins. I don't know, I'm feeling goblins. Oh, opponent's saying something in chat. Okay. Oh, okay. This is some Black Red Reanimator action, I would guess. The Innistrad Revenue Services. Of course they play Black Red Reanimator. And they have animated that. Yeah, you know what? That's... You got this. You got this. Here we go. Let's go to sideboarding. I want these. I want this. I want that. And then these can go. These can go. And then we gotta cut one more card. Oh, bah. I guess Shepard. Ah, Shepard's not that bad, though. Yeah, but we don't need four. Let's try this. Almost goblins, yeah. They got the biggest goblin of them all. The Griselbrand. You guys remember, when I first saw Griselbrand, I read it as Geiselbrand. Because it would make so much more sense in German. And that basically means burning hostages. Or hostage burning. And that's not exactly what it does, I guess. Hey Sam, thank you so much. Thanks for the two matches. We're gonna keep this. Thanks for those two matches. Those are really close, especially the last one, man. How did you finish your league? You must have started a second league as well. Because oh no, we got paired again because I finished my league, right? So I hope you also get a good league. Doesn't have best elf? Oh, I don't know about that. We were so scared that you would have a second Vines of Fastfoot there because we felt like it's the only thing that could make sense. But then we couldn't win anyway. And 3-2? Oh, that's good. Just talking about my hotel in Kenya. I really want to go next year. Want to go back next year if the situation allows. Well, not my hotel, right? I work for that place. Sometimes feels like my hotel because it's basically a bunch of friends and we're running that hotel. It's just really, that's just like such a cool thing. Okay, well, they must have, I mean, that doesn't mean that they must have something, but it feels like wear tear. Okay, nothing. That's good. Das is good. Let's run out. Do you want the extra Dryad Arbor? You know what this is actually gonna be? It feels like this is gonna be Assassin's Trophy. But I can't say for sure, of course. I'm gonna play it like this because for some reason they have a removal spell for like both my creatures and I can't activate this. Or like rather for just Dryad Arbor. It's like a really weird Konokai scenario, I guess. Okay, more Lotus Petals. I'm scared. Maybe they literally just have like destroy all permanents your opponent has. And we're like, oh shit. I guess we can force their action from Thoughtseize now. Oh, there goes forcing the action. I wonder if they're gonna take the Shepherd. Are we in this league? Oh, this is just the second league art. Yeah, that was something. So if I was them without any further information, I would probably take the Thoughtseize. Because I assume they must have something that's at least somewhat okay. Yeah. Just take 3 damage. Ambush Wipeout. Ambush Wipeout would actually be the insane blowout there. Can I afford to play the Heritage to it? Like, the scenario is end of turn, get rid of the ley line, then play looting, then play Exhume, and I'm fucked, so let's keep the Heritage to it. Even though, like, the big upside, of course, is if I draw Cradle, then I can activate this and yada yada, but I'm too scared of the other thing. By the way, Tochen! Thank you, number 4 in the Grimms chain tonight. Just saw it. There were so many things going on. Thanks for joining us. We already doubled our daily daily sub goal. This is already one of the highest sub totals I ever had. I think I have like something like 70 far. Oh no, no, we got more guys. We're close to 80. We're close to 80 with in subs. I think the highest I ever had like was like 93 or something. So thank you so much for that. You guys make such a big difference for me. Both with regards to like money, not gonna lie. Like all of this and the studio equipment is here or there, all of that kind of stuff. That's on you. And also like just hanging out in chat and having a great time with me. That's just like the thing that actually makes me want to start the stream. And here we go.
Finish him.
I would have really liked to learn what their removal for Leyland was before we finished this, but I mean, I guess we couldn't. Thanks, man. Thanks for stepping by. Have a great day, night, work, day, and next stream. By the way, you definitely should, if you're watching me stream, definitely check out Sam, Fenrir's Cloud. The best infect player in the world right now, and also super high production value stream. So if you like that, head over there. Thanks, Ginger Matt. So opponent is beginning the game with 7 cards in hand. On the draw, you know, this is so tempting, but we basically only have 14 initial mana sources. Oh, 13 actually by now? I think it's 13 plus 6, yeah, 19, yeah. So let's not do that. I'm gonna do this. I'm not thrilled. Maybe I should have mulliganed to Leyline. Maybe that would have been better. It's just like, when I see these three, I'm just immediately drawn towards it. Serenity is one of the things, yeah. Serenity, Assassin's Trophy, Chain of Vapor. I think Chain of Vapor has fallen out of favor though. Maybe Abrupt Decay, but probably not. Looting. It's pretty tech, yeah. I've played the mirror quite a lot. And the additional idea behind that was that I can put it on Wizards in the Rug Delver matchup, because it kills unflipped Delvers and it turns off Dreadhorde Arcanists. So I'm like, maybe. But thus far it hasn't been great and that kind of stuff. Okay, so this feels like Exhume or Animate Dead. And you know what usually happens in spots like these? You thought sees them, and then you see both Exhume and Animate Dead, and you're like, ugh. But here we're actually gonna see only Exhume, and we're gonna take it along with 3 lands left in the hand. Wait, oh, Shallow Grave? This is Shallow Grave. No, this is nothing. Oh, this is smart. Oh, opponent is smart. Because I definitely wouldn't have... Actually, would I have taken the Grizzlebrand 1, 2, 3, 4, 5? Yeah, I would not have taken the Grizzlebrand. Why is it not the graveyard, by the way? Why did they not discard it to Faithless Looting? It's like so weird. They could have kept Lotus... No, they could have not kept Lotus Petal. They could have kept Swamp, I guess. Maybe they were actually gunning to maybe hardcast it. On the draw, yeah, it's like very borderline on the draw. Problem is like, on game 2, I would very likely mulligan it. In game 3, not so much. If the opponent keeps 7. Wait, you got something? Ooh, okay, I think we're dead. As far as I remember, we don't have any kind of out against this in the main deck. Or in the sideboard. Yeah. I've won against it in the past with like a big ooze. But, yeah, that's not working here. Oh, 0-2 start. This fucking fly is still there. I can actually lift it up with my fingers, but I don't want to like squish it in my hand. That feels like wrong. But, and also disgusting. Yeah, I totally agree. I think the 5 is worse though. Yes, I've played every kind of imaginable mix between trophies and decays. Dr. Bill, 6 months in the Glimpse Chain, enjoy your new sub badge. Thank you so much for your support. So yeah, like I said, the difference between them is actually quite big. So for example, the big upside of trophy, of course, is that you get to bigger stuff, even though that's less relevant now because there's like no humility and stuff. But you get to disrupt the Dark Depth combo, which is probably the biggest upside. The downside is that it can get countered, which is like so obvious, right? But that's a real downside when you think that what you want to hit with it, you really want to hit with it. And the thing you want to hit the most out of like Hate Bears is Dreadlord Arcanist. And if they go Dreadlord Arcanist and you go Trophy and they daze, it's so bad. Like, it's so bad. And that's why I'm on 3 and 0 right now. I can't imagine like 3 and 1 if I want one more, and I wouldn't hate having one more, but that's just like how it is right now. We can only have so many cards in the sideboard. The 4-4 split, yes. Every time before I take my crazy pills. I missed the... I have no idea what's going on with those flies. I missed it, but I like... 1 millimeter apart from it, or I don't know, like half Fahrenheit or something. And it just sits there and it chills. It's like, I have no idea what to do. Those flies are high as fuck. I guess I like that there's light here. Maybe I should go back and stream in the dark, like excessive profanity. You guys know excessive profanity, by the way? Do we have any excessive profanity fans in here? Okay, so when can they play it? Until the end of your next turn. So they can still play the lightning bolt, which is unfortunate. But I guess it would go to my face either way. So I might as well just do it like this. Come on, I must have some fans of excessive profanity. Like the streamer, not the concept. In chat. Man versus game and excessive profanity, that's like the stuff I watch. Even though I'm sometimes a bit... I vary for man, sometimes. Both like as a general concept, as like mankind, but also like for the streamer. I don't know how it works. I just like come up with a random unit that I've heard. Okay, so... thus far nothing too bad has happened yet, right? Come on, Symbiote. Oh, Arda! Arda is gonna be good next turn. Is it though? Because our mana is really awkward next turn. So next time we can attack for 16, which is not enough. Because we need to tap like tap, 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 tap. And then we got plus 4. Actually, it's less than 16. It's 14, something like that. This is 4, this is 9, yeah. But if we draw an extra land, then we can attack for 19. Assuming they got nothing, of course. Yeah, in the reanimator matchup, I would consider bringing it in. But it's not a matchup I would consider, really. It also helps in a lands matchup if you get to a tabernacle. But like, when I build my sideboard... it sounds so cocky, but I'm building my sideboards to win tournaments, not games. Which sounds really cocky, I know. But I think... okay, this is the most cocky thing I've said in a while, but I think success proves me right on that one. I really just think about the most common decks, maybe the four, maybe five most common decks, and probably not even the five. I really think about like the three or four most common decks, and those I target really hard. And then for the rest, I have some overlap. I try to create some overlap, but I will not go out of my way to create that kind of overlap. And then I go into a tournament, and I just like, I want to hit those matchups, and I want to feel good about that. And on top of that, I can sometimes like outplay my opponent because people usually play horrible against elves and that kind of stuff and wiggle my way through, and then I'm in the top 8 and then I want to win. And I don't want to be like, oh, I want to be like 55% against everyone, because then there's like variance can go so wrong. And I'd rather have the matchup variance go wrong than the in-game variance. Okay, so we can attack for 16 here. Is that good enough? Could be. What is this, by the way? Creatures you control gain trample under... yeah, that's probably not what you want. Draw... what? Oh, because it... okay. 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 Ah, it's not that bad with this, I guess. Wait, we just got Fire Blasted? Oh no, we got Bedlam Rebel. You know, now I wonder whether I should have waited. I'm gonna go for it. Yeah, I'm probably gonna lose. Because now they get 5 free damage, and then just like 1 lightning bolt kills me. Yeah, that was a bit loose. That was a bit very loose. Wait, they have Groove and they have the opponent life gain thingy. Oh, they must have Punishing Fire then. Is this actually... Oh, wow, is this the deck? I heard about this deck in our Discord. Somebody came back to Magic and they played like a mid-range burn deck. And it was said to actually be pretty good. So now we lose to Fire Blast, but for the... Not against... Mark! Okay.
Mark.
Mark. Mark. Mark.
It's back.
Mark, how are you doing? I saw the sushi you posted on Instagram today. That was you, I remember. And your 5-4 got posted? I haven't looked at it yet. Oh, we actually lose to Fire Blast. I even said it. I said we're gonna lose to Fire Blast. Okay. Let's see what we can do post-burn. I have no idea what the burn deck with Punishing Fire is doing. I guess that must be Punishing Fire, right? Some kind of Punishing Fire. So these. And... Oh, we can actually keep some stuff. Let's try this. Doesn't have any kind of raw meat. Oh, I'm so sorry I called it sushi in front of your girlfriend. I apologize. I didn't take good enough of a look, and nobody reads descriptions on Instagram anyways. My boss once wanted me to have like really long descriptions on our Instagram posts, and like we were like, no, that's really not how it works. Like, you can do a bunch of hashtags, but if you, like, add a really long story. Maybe if you had the time, but we don't have the time. She didn't hear, that's good. Oh, fuck shit. Fuck this shit. And I guess this means they can't flashback their looting. Hey, our cap is Oh, come on. Well, we have no way to remove this. So, but honestly, like, we're gonna draw so many cards, it might not even be meta. Unless I have Mass Removal. Maybe I'm really misjudging this, and this is really not like a burn deck, and more like a control deck. That just plays a bunch of aggressive creatures, yeah, that wouldn't make sense. But not making sense is how you beat us. When we have a very one-dimensional draw. Okay, let's draw Progenitus now. That's the next step. Okay, never mind. I mean, we have 5 power in the second turn. There used to be a time in Legacy where this was, like, really good. Oh, there was kimchi in it? I ate kimchi when I was in Beijing. But I want to go to the actual Korea and have actual Korean kimchi. And, like, I really want to go to Korea either way. Are we gonna double block? 2-4. I think we're gonna double block. This is probably like this cap. We're playing against Burn at the end of their second turn. We are on 21. What the fuck? Man, I wish the National Order would work. Let's just get this out. Okay. So we got 7 mana next turn, so we can't hardcast Behemoth yet. Soulscar Mage. So what does it actually do again? If a source you control would deal non-combat damage to a creature and the opponent controls, put the many. Oh, okay, so basically their burn spells have Wither, I guess. That's what it's called. Why does it have to be a 1-2? Pendlehaven now! Okay. They really don't care about our life total, do they? We got no black spells in the deck, right? So we might as well just... Okay, now that's a good one. But yeah, we gotta find either a Glimpse Chain or a Hardcast Behemoth. Jarvis gotta pick it out. And we drew another one. Now we got the full house. We got Visionaries full of symbiotes. Oh, well, there goes that. We got another one. The flies, they keep touching me. Come on, Glimpse. Can you please stop? If you go to a historic place in China, all over the place they will tell you, like, if you go to the Summer Palace in China in Beijing, that was, wow, that was incredibly impressive to me. But all the signs, they always read like, hey, yes, while this place is beautiful, it actually used to be much more beautiful before the colonial forces, like the French and like the British and stuff, they destroyed everything. They are very bitter towards them, even to this day, I feel like. Okay, parasitic pillar. Okay. It's a little bit annoying, but we can actually, like, raise that. I think if they attack here. It's like, I really don't have many outs against the cage. And it can't. What if I double block? Nah, I'm just gonna take the damage. Just gonna take the damage and hit back for 2, 4, 6. That actually makes it really awkward for them as well. I'm doing fine, Drisky. Like, I had a really weird day because I was super tired yesterday. I was doing a lot of biking. And then in the evening, I was so tired, I fell into bed and I slept too long. Like, I slept longer than I should have today. Too far. So, every time I get up a little later than I should, or like quite a bit later than I should, I'm feeling kind of groggy throughout the day, but now I'm feeling good again. Honestly, because stream is going awesomely. I'm having a really great time on the stream today. And you guys make that for me. Like, when I was about to start the stream, I was like, do I really want to stream? I'm feeling a little bit, but then I was like, no, it's gonna be great. People are gonna be awesome. Yeah, Charles, I'm really not sure whether Pillar is actually gonna help them all that much. So they can block the biggest guy. They will probably block this one, though. So 2, 4, 6, yeah. Then what? I guess, once again, the thing that they can do is try to Fire Blast something here. Jim, thank you so much. I'm really happy to hear that. Gonna make you blush. If somebody's gonna make anyone blush, then I'm gonna be the only one to see. Okay. So now they're down to 2 life. I'm on 15, they have 1 card. You know what? I'm gonna do it. I'm reckless. Reckless is me. Man, it would be so sweet if you had something like... Oh, I could have killed them this turn, by the way. By the way, you guys like the camera quality? That's something I really wanted to get. Okay, we won. That was interesting. I wonder whether I want to prop... So they are much slower than I thought they would be, so maybe Genesis is gonna be better than I thought it would be. And then something like this, maybe? On the draw, like on the... They make your mana better. On the draw, you slightly... Yeah. Like, the thing I like them the most for is to just, like, play them on first turn to get a really explosive second turn with something like Null Sentinel and Heritage Stewards. I'm not sure I need 3 of those. But on the other hand, like, they seem to rely a lot on their creatures to deal damage. So I think I'm gonna try that. I'm gonna do this. Oh god, the fly. It can barely fly anymore. It needs help, it needs actual help, but I don't... This is so weird when that's like a thing that... Okay, I'm gonna ignore the fly. Opponent wins with 7 in hands. What am I this? I'm gonna keep this. Ba-da-da. Wait, no attack? Oh, it doesn't have haste. So bad. This was printed in the last 2 years, it would have haste. Betcha. Yes, you can fetch. Okay, so the question to whether you can fetch... Oh no, actually... You can't fetch Dryad Arbor against that, but you can fetch Dryad Arbor against Containment Priest, but it will go straight into exile. But against Grafdigger's Cage, you cannot fetch. I guess you can fetch, but you can't find. Okay, so this is gonna work. This is, like, much more aggressive now. I can just, like, play this and get Progenitus next turn. Is that good? Because I'm feeling like I want to get Dryad Arbor here, but then if that dies, that sucks. So let's not get Dryad Arbor here. Could have also just played Cradle, I guess, but that gives them more incentive to kill one of my creatures. On the other hand, Cradle gives me some more explosive draws if I draw Cradle into Cradle. Just hope they don't kill me. Oh my god, this is actually insane. Okay, so Lightning Bolt deals 6 damage here. That might have been the sound of the Secret of Mana. It's part of the playlist, yeah. What does Fetch Land, Arbor, and Grafdigger's Catch? You just can't click it. Just can't click it. You can click it against Containment Priest, though. Oh my god, this is insane. I think I'm just gonna take the damage and pray that I can get there somehow. Wait, they had nothing, though. Wait, post-combat light up the day? What the fuck? Wouldn't this... Wait, makes no sense. What the fuck? Post-combat light up the stage. Not sure Progenitus does help me all that much there. If this was a bird for ranger, this would be so much better. Can get Heritage to it. Can get Birchlow Ranger, I can tap this. None of those. I kind of want to kill them, which is like the problem. And it feels like I can't really kill them because there's no creatures in the graveyard and stuff. Oh, you can only... Oh, that's a good point. Spectacle, yeah. It's not like one mana draw two. Yeah, I remember that. I remember watching a streamer who did that. And he went... Like, he put Magic on and Blast. Oh, these flies. I can't think of so many flies annoying me here. But they seem to be about to die. Hellar Spirit Keeper isn't played right now. Does anybody in chat know? Maybe in some other format. So, anyway. I can fetch Dryad Arbor and attack for 16. Attacking for 16 down to 3. I can fetch Quirin Ranger. It does nothing. Dryad Arbor kill, attack for 16, take them to 3. So if I have to pass the turn, I might as well just play the Ooze and something else. An Abrupt Decay, maybe. What if I play the Ooze and then Abrupt Decay something? Then I can't eat it, so I would need to play Ooze first. Then that doesn't work. They don't have Trample, I guess. Unless they actually have that spell they had earlier that gives them Trample. Do you have only 2 cards in hand, though? I wanna Abrupt Decay something and then eat it with Ooze, and I cannot do that, and I wanna do that. What if I get Heritage to it here? Tap. Okay, so I can do that. I can get Heritage to it with Cradle. 3 mana, 1 black. Abrupt Decay this. 2 mana floating. Gain 1 life with Ooze. Is that actually okay? Play the Ooze, eat Faithless Looting. Well, I don't know, I kinda wanna... if they were to tap out for Faithless Looting, isn't that okay? I wanna gain life. Like the looting, like the best case scenario for them, yeah, I guess I see that. Best case scenario for them is to looting into a Lightning Bolt or Fire Blast or something. I'm just wondering whether I lose anyway. Oh, you know what I could do? I can do this. There's still one left. Okay. And now I can actually eat the Faithless Looting and still have mana, but I guess that mana doesn't do anything. And I guess I can actually do it like this. I think that's actually the best. I think I like this the most. Could have been modern, huh? So they got the land, and now we will see. Vanishing Fire. Okay. It's a little slow. So now I really want to draw a 1-mana creature here. Oh, I guess it could also be a 2-mana creature. Now it can only be a 1-mana creature. And then I attack for 16 if it's a 1-mana creature. But there's a world where I make the glimpse work then. Yeah, that's an attack for 16. That's so bad. It's exactly 16. Honestly, maybe I should have just gotten Progenitus and called it a day. This. Yeah, you know, I should have just gotten Progenitus because that would have killed one of those on the attack. I guess. Anyway, so next turn they can buy both of those back if they want to, or just like one. And then do this on one of my blockers. Yeah, all of this sucks. No, I have not played Historic. Feels like we might be losing this. At this point, they can just... They will probably kill me quicker with Punishing Fire than Progenitus could ever kill them. They can buy two back. So I got a 5, they shoot me down to 3. Then the next one shoots me down to 1. Then they buy one back and kill me. Yeah, they kill me next turn, actually. So I can only kill them with Glimpse of Nature here. Okay, Bedlam Reveler. That's also a really good draw. So maybe they drew 3 lands and we draw Nettle Sentinel into Heritage Druid or something. They can still disrupt that though, which is kind of annoying because of Punishing Fire. Okay, we gain life. Just give me that life. I guess at this point they can Punishing Fire the Visionary something, or my face. Yeah, my face. Oh, Visionary here, okay. So this is probably a good one. I guess if we draw... Do we win if we draw Natural Order? That's 10 plus 9. 19. They block 5. Or rather 4. They get to... I think Natural Order kills them. No, they get to stay in one life. If you draw Natural Order. Shepherd. Well, okay, we can try. We can try. We need more Haste Elves. Oh, never mind. Well, I guess we were gonna die anyway. Buy one back. Buy two back, actually. Shoot me. Well, if they have another land, yeah. Maybe I mistapped. On the other hand, I wanted to keep this for a potential attack. Feels pretty dead here. Actually, if I attack flows, I'm dead. Can't even attack with this one, because that makes me... That puts me dead even if they don't have an extra land. Because then it's just like fire at an attack and I can't block both. Did they have the land, by the way? Let me check. Oh yeah, that the land, because that's the second groove. Yeah, they got us. Is this the 0-3? Oh my god. Oh, that's too bad. That's too bad. Are we gonna try another one? You know, we're gonna try another one. We're gonna try another one. Xylophone, hey. That was really interesting. I wonder whether I should just like ignore all the abrupt decay stuff and go straight for a combo, especially on the play. Oh, that's you, Surferic Vortex, okay. That was quite interesting. Like, this feels like much more of a mid-range aggro deck. Not like a burn deck. Like, initially I thought it was going to be a burn deck, but turns out it's much more mid-range. The card that was actually quite interesting was the one that just cycles, basically, that gives all your creatures trample. I guess that makes sense in a prowess deck, right? Does it give all your creatures trample until end of turn, or just one of them? Got scared at the end there. Yeah, we could have put you to one, I believe. There have been like a couple of scenarios where we could have put you to one, but we could never put you below one. Crash through. That's exactly the kind of name I would give that card. Crash through. That Gravedigger's Cage got us so good. You probably figured it got us good. It got us really good. We had three natural orders in hand. Yeah, I guess it makes more sense in a prowess deck than in a burn deck, right? Because it allows you to clear blockers. And then you also get like the extra value of prowess. Wait, I did still beat the Gravedigger's Cage? Which kind of game was that? Or was it the one where they also had Sylphuric Vortex and were basically locked under their own vortex? We've played so many burn decks. Didn't we just like play a burn deck before? No, that was the same game, right? Let's see. Oh, Pillar, yeah, that's what I meant. Pillar is what I meant. Parasitic Pillar. Yeah, we're gonna keep this. This is exactly where Once Upon a Time is in the deck. Don't let us down. Don't let us down. Come on, come on, come on. Don't force this. Nobody has ever forced this. Maybe one day they will. Okay. I'm gonna run out this one because I don't want to get wastelanded and then have no mana. Here we go. By the way, anyone watching the Tour de France? Who do you think is gonna take it? I mean, we still have the Alps coming, right? All the big stages. And the final mountain time trial, which actually isn't as much as of a mountain time trial as I thought it would be, but it still looks like pretty good. This is working so good thus far. I really hope they're not gonna be show and tell. Because every time it goes like this, you're like, haha, we're setting up for a really good turn. And then your opponent's like, this is cute, ancient tome, show and tell. Oh my god, come on. Come on, man. Can we just wait here? By the way, we can actually kill them next turn. Like, I really just wanna get something that gives me value, but I mean, when you can kill them next turn, why should you, right? Maybe we even draw the Sour Shepherd. Sweet. Uh-oh. Wait, do you really wasteland there? Okay. 2, 4, 6. We can actually attack for 7 here. I think I'm just gonna keep drawing cards. Something like this. Sorry. There's still just one fly remaining. There were two flies and they dropped. I think. This one's still around. Oh, they have force? Okay. You got force. Force pitch stifle. Okay, so what's the plan? Just gonna hit you. Oops. They could dazed us, but it also means no Dreadlord Arcanist for them. I guess we already knew that they didn't have Dreadlord Arcanist, because they would have probably played that. Yeah, I also really like the song. Really like it. Foul, that's what I'm doing. Foul, that's already what I'm doing. Went from 20 to 19, and I have two Once Upon a Times in it. This is actually, it should say on the bottom right. It's a song from, which one is this? This is StarCraft 2, right? I think this is from StarCraft 2. It's part of the Terran theme. But Terran has the best music in StarCraft 1 and StarCraft 2 either way, like, without any doubt. They have the best music in StarCraft 1 and 2. By the way, what did they... have Lightning Bolt? Okay. I guess we're just gonna do it here. Okay, that's why we're easily racing them. Okay. I wanted to make this quick because they could have actually lightning bolted the Dryad at end of turn there. It's great, right? It's really, really good. I gotta say, Protoss has like really boring music in either of those two games. And Sorg is like hit or miss. They could have bolted Wild, but yeah, but they didn't. I don't know, maybe internally they have already given up. Or maybe their plan is to race me, but that seems pretty far off thus far. Like, if this was game 2 and they didn't use the bolt there, I would be like, oh shit, oh shit, oh shit. Is this gonna be rough tumble or something? Astronic, yes, you were gifted a sub earlier today by Finn Dorsal, I believe. So, I like this. I like this. And then maybe these? I don't know. I'm actually not sure what we're even playing against. It's hard to tell whether it's like Blue Red or Rock. Some people are trying to make Grixis work. I think I'm gonna go with this. Wait, didn't I actually want to try to Plague Engineers in this kind of matchup? On the draw, 3 mana, that seems a little bit tall for order. Plague Engineers against the creature type that we name. Okay, that's such a smart-ass move. Now, it helps a lot in the mirror. Like... Does it, Julian? Yes, it does. Oh, I gotta try. No, it helps a lot in the mirror, which is a lot more common these days. And the idea was to try it against Drug Diver to name Wizard, so you can like kill unflipped divers and also turn off Dreaded Arcanist because its power becomes 0. Problem is, Dreaded Arcanist is its best when it goes like Bolt, Flashback Bolt, and that still happens against Dreaded Arcanist. So, I can see replacing those with something else in the near future. Okay, this is a really slow opening, but I don't hate it. Since we're on the draw. On the draw, it's kind of like, give us some kind of acceleration, maybe. It's so funny, when you play against Delver decks and you're like, oh, I can have acceleration. Usually, like the main point, not the main point, but what usually happens is your kind of acceleration actually slows them down because they gotta kill it on their second or first turn. So they don't get to do what they wanna do. Which is like, anti-acceleration, I guess. There's probably a fancier word for that. Can't remove that. Plague Engineer Plague. Now that's actually interesting. Engineer Plague doesn't work nearly as well with Once Upon a Time, though. Spellsnare the Visionary, go away. Spellsnare is criminally underplayed, I think. Is it, though? We need a Spellsnare for converted mana cost 3. Negative tempo. Not even, right? Because it breaks even on tempo. So I guess our potential plus tempo is their actual minus tempo, and then evens out at 7, so yeah. Oh no, don't, I wouldn't do that. Like 19 is already, like, 20 used to be the gold standard for so many years, and going to 19 is already like, eh. And that's where we are right now, and I don't want to go further down thus far. You guys think they might have shuffled away the Spell Snare? Maybe they're gonna shuffle away the Spell Snare in the near future. They'll probably keep it on top right now because we could play some 2-mana stuff. Also, watch me play everything pre-combat like a noob. It is still human, actually. It still has a human face. Okay, it's actually Rock Diver. Okay. There's actually a world where I play this, just so they maybe don't have a blue pitch card to force. Doesn't feel great though. Maybe I want to play this first. It all depends on... Oh, interesting. Oh, this is actually really cool. Check this out. I do like this. And then I'm going to play Visionary. And if they do the thing where they try to kill this to Spell Snare the Visionary, then we are still up a card. Because we can just bounce it in response, unless they have Sudden Shock, I guess. But then they can Spell Snare. Mike, I know exactly what you mean. I once lost a really which turned out to be a really important match, because I thought the thing, like the flipped thing in the eyes, I looked at it and it looked as if it had wings. So my opponent, I had a board of like 10 creatures, and I was like, it's low life. And the only thing they had was thing in the eyes, and once I untapped, I could just like crack back and kill them. Maybe I should have actually do something else here, by the way. I should kill them. And I didn't block, and my opponent must have been like, I got away with murder, because I just looked at it, yeah, had his wings, can't block his flies. Okay, maybe I should have actually just gotten Financial Order there. Anyway, I don't want to use this, because then they can destroy this, like all my hopes and dreams. Don't like it when they take away all my hopes and dreams. Been there before. Is there any way... What if I just get Ooze? And then I do this. And then I do this. Okay, so basically the way I'm losing is mass removal, right? So I'm actually gonna get Ooze. And I'm gonna use my current Ranger. No, wait, that doesn't even make sense, because there wouldn't be any creature in the graveyard for me to eat if they have mass removal. Yeah, Julian, so smart. Look at this guy. Did I just pay 2 for like no value? Nah. Well, I guess I would have had 1 floating, so it wouldn't make sense. Kind of want to draw Abrupt Decay, because like the way I'm losing is mass removal. And having Abrupt Decay makes it so that post-mass removal it's not as bad. Actually, I shouldn't attack with this one. Do I want to trade for this? Be my guest. That's basically exactly what Overvoltage there says. They flipped everything, and then it was my turn. I put it all straight back down, and then it was their turn. They had attacked me again, and I was like, yeah, okay. And I was ready to untap and just kill them. And that turned out to be the loss that didn't put me into top 8 eventually. I mean, of course, the tournament would have played differently. I would have played against different people, so I can't really say that. But yeah, man, I think I missed the top 8 on tiebreakers eventually. Double best friends. Double best friends and their friends. Okay. They set it up with Brainstorm. They should show me Spell Snare again, yeah. Chat, without looking it up, what's the German name of... Oh, they're shuffling it away. Okay, cool. What's the German name of Spell Snare? It's amazing. It's an amazing name. Amazing is an amazing word, by the way. I like English words that you can pronounce in to convey the feeling that they are meant to convey. Like, amazing. Sad. Amazing. Agonizing. Okay. More cards to play that don't kill me, the better. Zauberschlinge.
Zauberschlinge.
Wildner Cuttle, Wilderner Cuttle. We call it Wilderner Cuttle. My favorite German one is probably like the Samen Schaukelhexe. Seed Cradle Witch. Or the one I always keep going back to if you're on my stream, that we should probably make that a meme. Rans Run Vanquisher. Überwältiger aus dem Zaunkönigrevier. That's like basically an entire sentence. Überwältiger aus dem Zaunkönigrevier. Some people would put a full stop on the end of that. Okay. So there's like no way I'm dead here. It's pretty good. Can I play Uber Safe by getting a second Shepherd? What is this gonna be? Yeah, that's not how it works, my friends. Okay. Here we go.
Finish him!
I guess I could have used this to untap something, but doesn't really matter.
Carrier has arrived.
Bah. Oh, we won the match?
Fatality.
That was so quick. Oh, that was one of the best articles I ever wrote. That was that article and the one about Eternal Weekend, where I think top 8 at Eternal Weekend. That was, those two articles were the best articles I ever wrote in my entire life. I put so much work into those, and I'm actually pretty sure I never actually wrote an article after those two, because I put so much work into those. And then I realized I don't get money for articles on my website, which was like, oh. I'm such a Zauberschlinge. Grossen Grip. Oh god, the sand. Check this out. I've kept hands like this before because this is actually an... Guys, come on, tell me to keep this. What's the pawn doing? Oh, they keep seven. Gotta mulligan it. I wish I could know, but I don't know. Okay, this is... It has visionary attacks. Keep it. Too late. Too late. Easy mal. Yeah, of course it's an easy mal. That's why we want to keep it. Oh, it's death in Texas. Oh, you know what? Might actually not be Death and Texas, might be Esper Wild. Oh, and Esper Wild is actually the main reason why at some point we started playing as Assassin's Trophy again, because Peacekeeper is really hard to beat. I guess technically you can also beat it with Plague Engineer, which actually works better than Abrupt Decay or Assassin's Trophy, because they kind of like Mother and stuff. Esper Wild is very much a meme, a real deck. Esper is really, a really, real, real deck. And it's really good. I would rate it in the top 5 decks in the format. And it's gonna get a real upgrade in the, I don't know what it's called, the one colorless, two white thingy that basically remove something, and once it comes back, it, let me figure this out first. Once it comes back, your opponent gets like a creature token that's as big as the converted mana cost of the spell or something. And Esper Wild doesn't really care about like random vanilla creatures, but it does care about like take. It's basically like a like an Oko on a stick that only works once, but you can abuse it with Esper Wild because that's what Esper Wild does. What are my top 5 then? Well, Rug Delver, and then I kind of want to say Pokepile, but that's kind of, it's not the same deck, it's very, very much not the same deck, but doesn't see enough play to really rate it that highly. So Rug Delver, some kind of Snowcore variant, but actually, you know, maybe Miracles. Maybe like the Snow Miracles thingy, but that's, I'm not too sure. So Rug Delver, Doomsday, Elves, Espavile, and then I'm not too sure about. Like those four, I'm really sure about the top eight, the top four. And then I would need some kind of inspiration to really tell you. Okay, so thus far nothing's really happening on their side, but also nothing's happening on our side. Skyclave Operation, that might actually be it. Oh, Thalia is so good, we can't attack into her. Okay. Actually, we don't have any basics anymore, right? Might as well fetch the last Bayou. Ninjas in the top 10? Maybe. Maybe. Could be. I don't hate ninjas. It's better than the meme deck than it looked to be. But it's also not like I'm feeling, oh yeah, this deck is really good, because it has kind of two different plans. And if you draw the wrong plan, it's really bad. Like if you draw the 4-4 plan and you're playing against a deck with like a bunch of death touches and stuff, it's really not that great, because it gives them so much time. But yeah, ninjas is better than, like, it's definitely above meme tier, but it's maybe top 10, I'm not sure. But like once you go beyond top 5, it's really hard to say anyway. Skeptic Toad! 8 months in the Glimpse Chain, thank you so much. What made you such a Skeptic Toad? Initially, I remember when I first heard your name, I thought you were like a Septic Toad. Hey Uwe, how's it going for you, man? Okay, why would some yet now? Needed in my life. I'm actually not sure what's going on the other side. Why is Thalia tapped? Oh, it attacked. That's an interesting concept. Oh, that's a good card. They can't play swords here. I guess they can if they Wirewood Symbiote their own Thalia. So no Shepard. I think Shepard is gonna come down once it actually like properly releases in paper, at least in Europe. Omnitail, I think Omnitail is okay. Omnitail is a very high floor. Blue-green Omnitail, like I'm actually higher on blue-green Omnitail, usually. Yeah, that's what I think about Omnitail. So do I actually order here? Not really, right? I just wait a turn, and then I try to kill them. Just curious what this is gonna be eventually. I think this is actually gonna be a recruit off the guard, and that can't really do anything. That can't actually do any real damage to us, can it? Oh, that would be actually that would make her really bad, right? But that would be flavorful. Just invented vigilance. Well, I invented vigilance 7 years ago when I attacked with my progenitors, and then I natural order sacrificed progenitors for the progenitors I just sacrificed. That card literally read 4 mana, untap your progenitors, but if it gets countered, it's gone. Okay, let's see what this is gonna be. Or maybe it's gonna be the double striker. And then they're gonna like destroy me with some crazy thing. Oh, Flicker is okay. Okay. You need 4 Shepherds, 2 Cradles, 2 Bayous. That's the most expensive card of the deck, right? I remember when Elves used to be a budget deck, right? And now look at it. Somebody in chat yesterday said that Elves is actually the most expensive deck of all like the proper decks in Legacy right now. Which I could actually believe, but I guess there's some decks who play a ton of like blue duels, which might make it super hard. Arcan, Legacy Council, thank you so much for the raid. If you don't know me, my name is Julian. My name is actually Frank. I just brand as Julian. You know, I trade as Julian for marketing reasons. I hit a marketing agency in Germany. They were like, no, Frank. Frank is not a good name to be a magic streamer. Do you know any magic streamer whose name is Frank? I'm like, actually, no. They're like, you should name yourself Julian. There's a guy in Europe who has won a lot of MCAMs and stuff, and you just like you pretend to be him. I wonder if there's actually people who pretend to be somebody else on Twitter and nobody noticed. Frank Lepore, okay. But I played against that guy in some kind of event, in some kind of Wizard-sponsored event, and I actually managed to beat him, I think. Or did he beat me? Oh wait, Frank Cast. Oh fuck, there's too many Franks. Okay, I'm never gonna work with that marketing agency again. Maybe I should just like rebrand as Frank. Does it even count as rebranding if it's just like your OG name? There's too many Franks, damn. Frank, okay guys, by the way, did you know there's a guy whose name is Frank Lepar? Okay, here we go.
Let's finish him!
What did they get, by the way, with the Flicker Wisp? Oh no, they can't get anything. They just take 25 damage. Because this is what you do. What if I do it like this? This is actually better. This actually deals more damage. Go. Kababoom. One more mana. Oh, Mrs. Thalia wants to be paid. She's the tax man or tax woman. Let's get the Krotov. Here we go.
Carrier has arrived.
Fish story, oh my god, yes, the fish story is great. And you know what's the best part about the fish story? The best part about the fish story is that at some tournament, I don't remember who it was, my opponent actually sat down with me, and as we were shuffling up, they told me, it's so weird that your real name is actually Frank, and I'd completely lost it at that point. Because apparently they had like, they thought that the fish story was real. And they literally thought that I wrote that story to explain why my real name is actually Frank, and I lost it. I couldn't believe it. So yeah. I still can't believe it. Oh, by the way, is Plague Engine actually going to be good against them? Do I have an easy link? I think I can find it on MTG, the source, Julian, Frank, Somalia. Names origins, there it is. I already have it. There it is. Oh yeah, I'm gonna link to it somehow. How do I link to individual posts? Oh, you click the 5 here. You're regarded? Okay.
Congratulations, you are the winner.
Are we gonna... I wonder, are the Plague Engineers gonna be good? Yeah, Uber, that's the big thing, right? It's slower. And it doesn't abuse Shepard nearly as much. So I'm... Pre-Shepard, I was like pretty 50-50 between the two lists. Post-Shepard, I'm super hard in on this. Like thinking that this is better. I want the Plague Engineers for the fucking meme value, right? It would just be so hilarious to get them with Plague Engineers. How big of the meme is it? You know, they're gonna put 2 in and remove the Shepherds entirely. Okay, I fucking blew at the fly and it didn't go away. How hard can you hit a fly? You saw my passport. I could actually believe you that you have seen my passport. Has Legacy Elves been played in any color combos? In any other color combos? Yes, we have white. Every once in a while, like, we had white in the deck, but it also used to be mono-green before Deathrite Shaman, and Abrupt Replicate, it used to be mono-green. So if you want to check out a mono-green list, GP Ghent 2012, Lucas Maurer, a friend of mine, went to the finals, was a huge inspiration for me to pick up the deck in the first place. Maybe he randomly splashed something, but I think he was mono-green, and I guess he had Ferry Macabre in sideboard, if that counts. Blue Splash I've tried to make work numerous times, didn't really work out. I guess it was okay. And, oh god, the worst I ever played. Okay, the worst Elves I ever played. Like, I've splashed a lot of things in Elves. And the worst thing that I ever put together under God's Earth was punishing Elves. That was so bad. That was the worst. That was actually worst. Why am I... Oh, no. Oh, because I'm... Okay. I thought, like, why am I going first? Punishing Elves was the worst I ever put together. I think it was actually worse than the but I had both Ad Nauseam and Tendrous Elves. because I was so desperate to beat top miracles, I thought like maybe end of turn ad nauseam can get them. Or like if you go for like a random turn and I just like grind them out with tendrils and stuff, those are bad, but punishing elves was the worst. What was the worst deck you ever played? Oh, Marius, I know, and you know too. We both know what the worst deck you ever played was. And a friend of ours actually built that deck right afterwards. Moonraker. I don't know which version of Moonraker it was, but it was Moonraker. Do we get to attack here? No, that's pointless. Fucking fly in my face again. Okay, I'm gonna snip you really hard now. Can you survive that? I guess you can. You get flying proof of that. I'm so sorry, guys. I hope the fly isn't too distracting for you, because it actually is incredibly distracting to me right now. So we're gonna play a pass here. Yeah, I hope Shepherd is gonna come down. So if we draw Heritage Druid here, that would be insane. Heritage Druid or Cradle. Cradle's actually okay. Oh, this actually helps us out quite a bit now. The best part is that we actually get to tap Mother of Runes. Because next turn they're gonna attack, and then... maybe even better, maybe they're gonna use Mother of Runes on the Stoneforge. Uh-oh. So if they're super... Okay, never mind. I was gonna say... Well, I guess we would hit the chit anyway. Because they could go to our turn, tap our Bayou, and then equip the chit and attack with the next turn, but then we would still hit the chit anyway. So at least... The Mother of Runes will have to tap this turn. There's like no way around it. What do you ban or unban any cards right now? That's like really nothing that strikes me as a card I want to unban, except for survival. That actually strikes me really hard as a card I want to unban. Okay, we're gonna wait for the damage, and then with the chitter trigger on a stack, we're gonna destroy it, unless they do something, I guess, but there's not too much they can do. So do I want to abrupt decay this thing? Not really, right? And ban, that's a whole other story. Like, my ideal legacy has a much lower power level than what legacy currently has. So if I want to, like, fix things in the... How do you say that? If I want to fix things like right now, like in short term... If I want to short term fix stuff, then I would get rid of Astrolabe, Oko, and Uro. Not even sure about Uro, like probably only Astrolabe and Oko. And Uro, then we will see. But if I want to do like my big cultural revolution, I guess what you call that. Like how do you call that when you like completely change the format again? I would also get rid of first of all Grizzlebrand, and then we will see Grizzlebrand Terminus. But ever since Top is gone, I'm much less annoyed by Terminus. Because Terminus against Elves, for example, is really interesting now. Do we just kill the Mother? They didn't even use the top by the port. They must have given up inside. You know what, we're just gonna get a bunch of mana here. Watch them use the port now. That would be funny. There's like, even Senate would be good here, because then we can Senate for a Heritage Druid. Virtual Rangers would be okay. This is post-combat, by the way, right? Yeah. First was a Sand E-Box. Oh man, I wish. Or is stronger than Oko, for sure. But without Wasteland, like actual proper Wasteland expecting format, I'm not so sure about it. That's why I would give it the benefit of the doubt. Could be Containment Priest. That's actually a good observation. Didn't notice. I remember when I played against Michael Bond at MKM. Which MKM was it? Madrid. And we had almost exactly this scenario. And he didn't port me. And I would have not natural ordered there. And he wanted to plant the seed of doubt in my head. Oh, that's sweet. But actually, this is really sweet. But I had the hard cast Behemoth anyway, so I was gonna win anyway. But that was like some really interesting play from him. Because he figured if he randomly taps one of my lands, it really doesn't do anything. So he's gotta sell the Containment Priest to at least stay alive for a turn. And I would have bought into it because I felt like I didn't need to go for it there. But yeah, I had the hard cast. Swords, okay. Well, Veil of Summer doesn't really seem to have that big of an impact on the format right now, interestingly. It used to have like quite the impact, but right now it's, I don't know, don't see it all that much. Is there any reason we should name Cleric? I think we're just naming Human. Why is this not a human? This looks human, right? Go away, fly. Whoa! I caught it! I caught it in my hand! And it was like so awkward, I made it go away. I guess that tells you how weird this fly is. I actually literally caught it in my hand. They have one card left. Guess this. I wonder if it's gonna be better Skylar Sword of Fire and Ice. Where is it? Sword of Fire and Ice, okay. So now I'm not even sure I wanna play the Plague Engineer. Actually, what if I go Abrupt Decay? Oh no, I can't Abrupt Decay. Doesn't make sense. Like, I can put this on Human, but then the Sword of Fire and Ice hits me with this next turn, so I don't really need to do that anyway, so I guess I'm just gonna do this. Is this a free attack? It's kind of free, but not exactly. I think we're just gonna wait and I'm gonna hit the Sword of Fire and Ice. I guess I could have untapped the Nettle Sentinel by replaying something. I guess the Abrupt Decay untaps it anyway. Well, this is Mozart. Actually, I gotta look into the music of Lemmings. I totally don't remember which kind of music Lemmings had. Does anybody remember the music? Did Lemmings actually have music? Because I don't remember Lemmings to have had music. Dun, 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 dun. I'm still waiting for Father of Ruins. One day they shall print Father of Ruins. And it's gonna give a player protection from a color. And it's gonna be insanely overpowered as such. Like, Father of Ruins giving a player protection from a color would be insanely overpowered. You couldn't print it as a 1-mana thing. I think you couldn't even print it as a 2-mana thing. You could consider printing it as a 3-mana thing. Would basically stop all the damage from creatures, discard, tendrils, what have you. Wait, we already got this? Oh! Oh yeah, okay. Hexproof, yeah, but you would still take damage from creatures. Imagine if somebody had Father of Ruins and could get protection from green. It's like, whoa. So, I hope you had a great time. I definitely had. We got a 5-hour in our first stream yesterday. We got a 4-hour in the previous stream. Now we went 2 and 3. Shit happens. If you like what you see, if you're on YouTube, give me a sub there. It really makes a difference. If you want to share your Amazon Prime sub, for example, just do that. If you want to just seriously follow this, hang out, have a great time next time I'm going to stream. And yeah, that's going to be it for me today. Maybe we're going to find out about the... Maybe we're going to actually include the Monkey Island soundtrack. The Monkey Island soundtrack should be amazing. But with that, we're going to send you somewhere. The whole first story is amazing. I'm glad you read it. And now you gotta imagine that somebody actually believed it. That's so cool. I actually felt bad for them because they actually like, they just took it for real. I'm gonna send you, who's streaming now? I'm gonna send you to Mr. Phil. Where are we? Raven, you. So guys, have a great time and see you again next time. Say hello to Phil from me.
Du unterliegst einer Fehlannahme. Unser wertvollster Aktivposten bist nicht du. Hey.